The Regal Cycle Company manufactures three types of bicycles: a dirt bike, a mountain bike, and a racing bike. Data on sales and expenses for the past quarter appear below. Management is concerned about the continued losses shown by the racing bikes and wants a recommendation as to whether or not the line should be discontinued. The special equipment used to produce the racing bikes has no resale value and does not wear out. Should the production and the sales of racing bikes be discontinued? Recast the data in a format that would be more useful to management in assessing long-run profitability of the various product lines. Let's first look at the change in our net operating income if we discontinue the racing bikes. If we discontinue the racing bikes, we'll lose our $27,000 contribution margin from the racing bikes, but we'll also be able to avoid some of our fixed costs. We'll be able to avoid the $6,000 in traceable advertising expenses if we eliminate the racing bike line. The depreciation on the special equipment used to manufacture the racing bikes is a sunk cost and is not relevant to our decision. The salary on the racing bike manager of $10,000 will be able to be eliminated if we drop the racing bike segment. Finally, the allocated common fixed cost of $12,000 will continue regardless of whether we produce or don't produce the racing bikes, so it's not relevant to our decision. So the total fixed cost that can be avoided if we drop the racing bike segment is $16,000. However, since we've lost our $27,000 contribution margin, we will have a decrease in our net operating income of $11,000. That's the $27,000 loss contribution margin, less our fixed costs. In terms of a more useful financial statement presentation for management, we can produce segmented income statements that separate out our common fixed expenses. We'll pick up our sales, variable cost, contribution margin, and traceable fixed cost for our racing bike line, and those are just as given. The only cost we've omitted is our allocated common fixed cost. We'll do the same thing for the mountain bikes and the dirt bikes. We can then total up our sales, variable cost, contribution margin, traceable fixed cost across the three product lines. And we have a product line segment margin of $92,000. Then we can deduct the $60,000 in common allocated fixed costs to arrive at our net operating income of $32,000. This gives us a better picture of the long-run profitability of each one of our product lines.